Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. In our previous video, we have discussed the integration of some specific type of integrals, that is these integration of square root of x square minus a square, root x square plus a square and root a square minus x square. And we have done the derivation of the integrals of this type. So those who want to see the solutions or the derivations of the integral of this type, they can just click on the I link. The description is given over there to see the derivation of these some specific type of integrals, as we are going to use the integration formulas of this type of integral in solving the questions related to exercise 7.7. As you can see, students, that we are having a quadratic equation in the square root. So basically this is the integration of this type, but we have to identify out of these three integrals which one it resembles. So let's see, when I will just shift in the make this function in the form of this form, you can see here that this is the integration of third type, that is square root of a square minus x square. See here, in place of a, I am having 2. In place of x, same x is there. So it resembles the formula of type third. Now what you need to do, you have to just apply the formula. And applying the formula, you can see here, x upon 2 square root of x a square minus x square, that is 2 square minus x square, plus a square upon 2, that is 2 square upon 2 sine inverse x upon a, that is sine inverse x upon 2 plus c. So the answer is x upon 2 square root 4 minus x square plus 2 square can be cancelled by 2. So this is the answer, students. See, this is very simple. Please note down. So students, next second question is integration of square root of 1 minus 4x square. So students, when you will observe this integral, you can see here the coefficient of x square is always 1. See here, this is also 1, this is also 1 and this is also 1. Hardly matters, it is minus 1, but we are having 1. So for that, to make this integral in this form, what we are going to do, we are going to take 4 common. So what do we get? 1 upon 4 minus x square. Now students, this 4 can be taken outside, as square root of 4 is equal to 2. So we can take 2 common outside and it becomes square root of 1 upon 4 can be written as 1 upon 2 whole square minus x square dx. Now again, this resembles formula 3, that is integration of a square minus x square. In place of a, I am having 1 by 2. So just apply the formula. The answer is going to be x upon 2 square root of a square minus x square plus a square upon 2 sine inverse x upon a plus c. So in the next step, you will observe this is going to be 1 upon 4, and if you will take the LCM, so we get 1 minus 4x square upon 4 plus 2 square becomes 4 and 4 into 2 becomes 8. So it becomes 1 upon 8 sine inverse. This 2 is actually in the denominator, so it will come in the numerator. So it becomes 2x upon 1, that is 2x plus c. In the next step, we'll just open this. So 2 will be cancelled by 2, but the square root of 4 becomes 2. So we get answer x upon 2 square root of 1 minus 4x square plus 2 when we cancel by 8, and we get 1 upon 4 sine inverse 2x plus c. So students, next is question number 3, that is integration of square root of x square plus 4x plus 6. So students, in this question, you can observe that this is not in the standard form, that is x square plus a square. So we will make this function in the form of complete square. Let's see how. See students, in this question, I can split this 6 into 2 parts, that is 4 plus 2. And in the next step, you can see here that this can be written as x plus 2 whole square, because a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab becomes 4x. And this 2 can be written as root 2 square, because students, you can observe that to apply the formula of this type of integrals, the function should be in this form, that is under root of whatever it can be, x square plus a square minus x square, a square plus x square. So both should be in the form of square. So now you can see this is in the form of square and it resembles the formula of type 2. So just replace x by x plus 2 and replace a by root 2. So what do we get? In place of x, I will get x plus 2 by 2 square root of x square. Sorry, in place of this, we are having x square plus a square. X square plus a square plus a square by 2, that is root 2 whole square by 2 log x. In place of x, I am having x plus 2 plus square root of x square plus a square plus c. So this is the formula. And in the next step, I am going to get answer, that is x plus 2 by 2. When I will solve this, I will get again the same function which I am having in the starting, that is x square plus 4x plus 6 plus root 2 holds, root 2 becomes 2 and 2 will be cancelled by 2. So I will get only 1, no need to write down 1, log of x plus 2 plus square root of, now if I will solve that x plus 2 whole square plus root 2 whole square, again I get the same function which is there in the starting, that is x square plus 4x plus 6 plus c. So this is the answer, please note down. So student, next is question number 4, that is integration of square root of x square plus 4x plus 1. Again, we have to make this function in the form of complete square. And in this, we are going to use complete square method. So for that, what we are going to do, let's see. Now in the complete square method, you know that we will add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. What is the coefficient of x? We are having 4. So if well, I will half it, I will get 2. So that means I have to add 2 square and subtract 2 square just to make in the form of complete square. This you have done in 10th standard also, and also in the formula to derive the formula of some special type of integrals in exercise 7.4 also we have done this trick. So in the next step, these three terms will become the formula of x plus 2 whole square, that is a square plus b square plus 2ab, and 2 square becomes 4 and 1 minus 4 becomes minus 3, and 3 can be written as root 3 whole square. So students, now this is in the standard form, that is square root of x square minus a square, which resembles the first formula. In place of x, I am having x plus 2. So just replace x by x plus 2. Square root of x square minus a square. In place of x, I am having x plus 2 minus a. In place of a, I am having root 3 minus a square plus a square by, sorry, in place of this I am getting a, because I told you that whenever I am having c, students, when a square is negative, so I will get negative a square. When a square is positive, I get plus a square. Here the coefficient of a square is positive, so again I am getting here a square positive. So see here, x upon 2, x upon 2, x upon 2 is same in all the formulas. The next thing is that you have to same write down as it is the function, whatever it is, that is square root of x square minus a square, square root of x square plus a square, square root of a square minus x square. In the next step, a square by 2, a square by 2, a square by 2 is same in all the functions. You just need to see the sign of a square. If it is negative, then you have to take minus a square. If it is positive, then you have to take plus a square. And in the next step, that is log x plus square root of x square minus a square. This is log x plus, in place of a square negative, in we get a square positive. For positive, we get positive a square. For negative, we get negative a square. And this is actually different type of integral. Square root of a square minus x square, we get sine inverse x upon a. So we get minus of a square, that is root 3 square upon 2 log x, in place of x I'm having x plus 2, plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. So this is the answer, x plus 2 by 2 square root of. Students, when you will solve this, you will get again the same function which is there in the starting. So that becomes x square plus 4x plus 1. You can also solve this by opening this by using the formula f plus b whole square and then minus root 3 square. So you get same this function. Root 3 square becomes 3. 3 by 2 log x plus 2 plus square root. You will solve this. Again, you will get the same function which is there in the starting. So this is the answer. Please note down. So student, this is next fifth question, that is the integration of square root of 1 minus 4x minus x square. Again students, whenever we are having a quadratic equation in the square root, we have to follow the complete square method. For complete square method, if you remember in 10th standard, the first step is that you should make the coefficient of x square always equal to 1. Here the coefficient of x square is negative. So first of all, you have to take negative sign common. So it becomes positive, 4x will become also positive and 1 will become negative. Students, one mistake that students used to do, they take negative outside. You can't take negative sign outside as root of minus 4. Because you know that this square root of minus 4 is not equal to minus of square root of 4. Because this is actually minus 1 can be written as iota square. So it is actually equal to plus minus 2 iota. It becomes complex number. So please, whenever we are having negative in the square root, we can't take negative common outside. Remember this thing, because many students do this mistake in the exam. So students, next step is that whatever the coefficient of x is there, you have to take half of it. Half of 4 is equal to 2. That means you have to add and subtract 2. Now students, in the next step, see here, these three terms will always make the formula. I told you that you don't need to just remember anything, just write down x and whatever whole square you have added or subtracted, take it as whole square. In between, if you don't remember what to take, whether plus or minus, that depends upon the coefficient of x. If it is positive, then you have to take positive. If it is negative, then you have to take negative. And the remaining thing is minus 1 minus 4, which becomes minus 5. Now students, again in the next step, because we are not having any formula of minus of x square minus a square, we are not having any formula of this type. So in the next step, we will again shift this negative sign inside. So 5 will become positive and this will become negative. And 5 can be written as root 5 square minus x plus 2 whole square. Just to make the formula in the standard form, because only then we can apply these three formulas. Now you can see here, this formula resembles third type, that is square root of a square minus x square. In place of a, I'm having root 5. In place of x, I'm having x plus 2. So the answer is x plus 2 by 2 square root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 sine inverse x. In place of x, I'm having x plus 2. In place of a, I'm having root 5. So this becomes x plus 2 by 2 square root of. If you will solve this, students, I told you that please don't waste your time in solving this. When you will solve this, you will get again the same function which is there in the starting, that is 1 minus 4x minus x square plus root 5 becomes 5 by 2 sine inverse x plus 2 upon root 5 plus c. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, next is question number 6, that is integration of square root of x square plus 4x minus 5. So you can observe here students that all coefficient of x square is automatically 1 here, so you don't need to make it 1. So next step, you just apply complete square formula. The coefficient of x is 4, taking the half of 4, that is equal to 2. So you will add and subtract 2 just to make this formula in the form of complete square. See, all the questions are same. So this is very simple exercise. So this is going to be x plus 2 whole square, and minus 5 minus 4 becomes minus 9, which can be written as 3 square. All of you know that 9 can be written as 3 square. So students, this is the formula of type first, that is x square minus a square. In place of x, I'm having x plus 2. So answer is going to be x plus 2 by 2 square root of x square minus a square. In place of a, I'm having 3 square minus a square by 2 log x. In place of x, I'm having x plus 2. Students, just forget about that. They just write down as it is x. So please remember, whenever we're having in place of x, whatever is there, we have to take only that value. X plus 2 square root of x plus 2 whole square minus a square plus c. So the final answer is x plus 2 by 2. And students, I told you that you don't need to solve this. You will get again the same function which is there in the starting. That is x square plus 4x minus 5 minus 9 by 2 log x plus 2 plus square root of, again you will solve this, you will get the same function, that is x square plus 4x minus 5 plus c. So this is the answer. Please note down. Students, next is 7th question, that is integration of square root of 1 plus 3x minus x square. So this the question we have done in question number 5 also. Here the coefficient of x square is negative. So first of all, we'll make it positive by taking negative sign common inside. So we'll get this. And now I told you that we can't take negative sign outside. So apply the complete square method inside this bracket. Here the coefficient of x is 3. So if I will half it, I'll get 3 by 2. So what I will do, I will add 3 by 2 whole square and subtract 3 by 2 whole square, because the formula is that we have to take half the coefficient of x whole square, add and subtract. Coefficient of x is 3, so add 3 by 2 whole square and subtract 3 by 2 whole square. In the next step, you don't need to learn any formula, just write down x, and whatever whole square you have added or subtracted, just write down that thing, whole square. In between, if you have to think about what to do, whether it will come plus or minus, that depends upon the coefficient of x. It is negative, so we get negative. And remaining thing is that we get minus 1, minus 3 square becomes 9 and 2 square becomes 4. So students, in the next step, what I will get, this is minus of x minus 3 by 2 whole square. And when you will take the LCM, 4 minus 4 minus 9 is going to be minus 13 by 4 dx. And this can be written as, again students, you will shift this negative sign inside, so it becomes positive, and it can be written as root 13 upon 2 whole square minus x minus 3 by 2 whole square. Just to make this formula in the standard form, that is a square minus x square. So students, if you will see this, this is resembling a formula of type 3. In place of x, I am having x minus 3 by 2. In place of a, I am having root 13 by 2. So the answer is x by 2, that is x minus 3 by 2 upon 2 square root of a square, that is root 13 by 2 whole square minus x square, that is x minus 3 by 2 whole square plus a square upon 2, that is a square upon 2, that is root 13 upon 2, this is a square upon 2 sine inverse x upon a plus c. In the next step, we have to just simplify this. So students, answer is going to be, if you will take the LCM 2 in the numerator, so it becomes 2x minus 3, and this 2 will come in the denominator, 2 into 2 becomes 4. So 2x minus 3 by 4 square root of, now students, when you will solve this, you will get the same function which is there in the starting, that is 1 plus 3x minus x square plus a square, root 13 becomes 13, and this 2 square becomes 4, 4 into 2 becomes 8. Sine inverse. If you will take the LCM in the numerator, it will be 2x minus 3. This 2 will be cancelled by 2. So in the denominator, I will get only root 13 plus c. This is the answer. Please note down. Next question is 8, that is integration of x square plus 3x. So students, just to make in the form of complete square, same process we have to follow in all the questions. The coefficient of x is 3. So if I will take half of it, I will get 3 by 2 whole square minus 3 by 2 whole square. So in the next step, these three terms will become the formula of x plus 3 by 2 whole square minus 3 by 2 whole square. So student, this is very simple question. If you will see, this is a formula of type 1, that is square root of x square minus a square. Just apply the formula, that is x upon 2 square root of x square minus a square minus a square upon 2 log x. In place of x, I'm having x plus 3 by 2 square root of x square minus a square, that is x plus 3 by 2 whole square minus 3 by 2 whole square plus c. So next step, we have to just simplify this. 2 can be taken as LCM, so it becomes 2x plus 3, and this 2 will come in the denominator, it becomes 2x plus 3 by 4 square root of. So students, I told you, when you will solve this, you will get again the same function which is there in the starting, that is x square plus 3x minus this 3 square becomes 9 and 2 square become 4, 4 into 2 become 8 log x plus 3 by 2 plus square root of. If you will solve this, you will get the again same function which is there in the starting, that is x square plus 3x plus c. So students, this is the answer. Please note down. So students, next is question number 9, that is integration of square root of 1 plus x square by 9. So in this step, you can make it, you can take 9 as the LCM, so you will get 9 plus x square dx. So 9 can be taken as outside, so I will get 1 by 3 integration of square root of this 3. 9 can be written as 3 square plus x square. So this is very simple. This formula resembles the formula of type 2, which is x square plus a square. So just replace the formula, I'll get x by 2 square root of x square plus a square by 2 log x plus under root of x square plus a square plus c. So this is the answer. X upon 2 into 3 becomes 6, and if you will solve this, you'll get again x square plus 9 plus 3 square become 9, 2 into 3 becomes 6 log x plus under root of x square plus 9 plus c. So students, in the next step, you can just cancel this term by 3, so you get 3 by 2. So this is the answer. Please note down. So students, next is very simple question, that is MCQ type in 10th question, that is integration of square root of 1 plus x square. So students, if you will see this, this function resembles this formula, and 1 can be written as 1 whole square. So just replace a by 1 in this formula, I will get x by 2 square root of x square plus 1. This is same, plus a square, that is 1 upon 2 log x plus square root of x square plus a square, that is 1. So automatically this is the answer, that is a part. Very simple, please note down. So student, next is also MCQ type question, that is 11 square root of x square minus 8x plus 7. First of all, this is not in the standard form, so we'll make in the standard form by using complete square method. Here the coefficient of x is 8, so if I will take the half of 8, we'll get 4, and I will subtract 4 whole square and subtract 4 whole square just to make this formula in the form of complete square. So this becomes square root of, so students, you can see here that I have added and subtracted 4. So this becomes x minus 4 whole square, because I have added 4 and the coefficient of x is negative. So it becomes x minus 4 whole square, and 7 minus 4 square is 16. So 7 minus 16 is 9. And it will come in minus, because 16 is negative. So we'll get minus 9, which can be written as x minus 4 whole square minus 3 whole square. Now it resembles a formula of type 1. So just apply the formula, you get the answer x minus x upon 2 square root of x square minus a square plus a, sorry, minus a square by 2 log x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. So when you will solve it, you will get same function, that is x square minus 8x plus 7 minus 9 by 2 log x minus 4 plus square root of, again you get the same function, that is x square minus 8x plus 7 plus c. Though this is the answer. So this, if you will see this, there are 4 options given in the book. According to that, the correct answer is option D. This is the correct answer, you can see there. Please note down. So students, here we have discussed the integration of some special type, that is integration of square root of quadratic equation, which is done in exercise 7.7. I hope so that you have understood all the questions and the derivations of these functions also. So I hope so that you like my video. In our next video, we are going to discuss exercise 7.8. Although that exercise has been deleted by the CBSE this year, that is in session 2020-21. But for the further session also, it will come, that is exercise 7.8. So students, please watch that video also, because for the competitive exam, maybe that topic will come. So stay tuned with us. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes.